Okay, so good morning, my dear students. Welcome back to your online classes. I hope you must be refreshed after your summer vacations. As you already know, we already started the chapter 3, squares and square root. We'll continue from the same chapter. So here are the properties of the square and square roots, which are already studied also. Now, the important properties are: the square root of an even number is an even number, and square root of an odd number is an odd number. Please write these properties in your notebooks, okay, so that you can remember them. So this you can see with some examples also. The square root of 4 is 2. Both of them are even, isn't it? Now here, the square root of 25 is 5. Both of them are odd number. You can take any of them and it is applicable to all the numbers. So the square root of even is even and square root of odd is odd. Now, if the unit digit of a number is 2, 3, 7 or 8, these important numbers 2, 3, 7 or 8, then it does not have a square root in the set of natural numbers. Other than these numbers, if the numbers have 0, 1, 4, 5, 6 or 9 at units place, it may or may not be the perfect squares. And third one is, the negative number of a square root is not existing in the system. For example, root over minus 25 is not equal to 5. Clear? This will come in the complex number you will study later on. So I hope the points are clear to you. I am requesting you all to write all the points in your notebooks. Square root of negative numbers are imaginary numbers. That's what it is told, and you'll be studying them in higher classes. Today we will see how to find the square root of a number. Three different methods are there. We'll be studying them one by one. First is prime factorization method. Next is the successive subtraction method. And then the final is the long division method. So to start with the prime factorization method, you know how to find the prime factors of a number. You will start, you know what are the prime factors, prime numbers. What are prime numbers? Prime numbers are the numbers which have only two factors, 1 and number itself. Okay, so when we will prime factorize 9, what we start? We actually start from the lowest prime number, that is 2. But 2 is not going to, 9 is not going to divide 2 completely. So let us take the next number, that is a 3. So 9 by 3 is a 3 and 3 by 3 is a 1. So we can write root over 9 is equal to root over 3 into 3. Now here, these two 3's will be considered as a single 3, and this symbol, this root over symbol will go away. Clear? Same way for 25, it will be root over 5 into 5. And when 2 are there, square root means these two numbers will be considered as one number. Okay, so the steps are given here. Write the prime factor of the given number. The number being the perfect square will have one or more pairs of same prime factors. So you have to form the pair. You will see pairs. Pick up and write one factor from each pair. So when we saw that we have a pair of 5 and 5, so its square root will be just a single number. Okay, if suppose the after prime factorization we are getting a number as 3 into 3 into 5 into 5. Now these two 3's will be considered as a single 3, these two 5's will be considered as a single 5, so the answer will be 15. Means the square root of this number will be 15. So same, they have given some examples. Find the square root of the following number by prime factorization method. They started the prime factorization till we get a 1. After that, what they have done? Writing all the numbers in the square root, that is 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 7 into 7 into 7 into 7. Now, these 2 are taken as a single 2. Now, these 2 together are written as a single number. This 7 together are written as a single number. This 7 again as a single number. So, the answer is 196. Clear? Now here are some of the examples, solved examples. They are very easy to do. See here, in example 2, they are asking find the smallest number by which 1800 must be multiplied so that the product is a perfect square. So they are asking, so 1800, actually 1800 is not a perfect square. Now they are asking, it is not a perfect square. They are asking with which number you will multiply so that it becomes a perfect square. So what we will do? First we will prime factorize the given number 1800. When you will prime factorize, you will get its factors as 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 3 into 5 into 5. Now you know for a number to be perfect square, all its prime factors should be in pair. Now here if you see, this 2 I can write them as a pair, this 3 I can write them as a pair, this 5 I can write them as a pair. Now this 2 is alone, okay? So in order to make it into a pair, what I will do, I will multiply this 2 with one more 2. And finally, we will get the answer. Okay, for a number to be perfect square, it should make pairs of all the prime factors as it is told. Here, 2 is left without a pair. Hence, we must multiply the number by 2 to make it a perfect square. So, when you will multiply 1800 with a 2, you will get 3600 and it is a perfect square. Okay, they are not asking what is the number, so we are not giving them the number. We are just telling them with which number. Now, same question can be asked by which number it should be divided. Look here. Find the smallest number by which 4056 be divided to make it a perfect square. Now, here again the steps will be same. You will prime factorize the number and you will see one of the number is left all alone. Which one is left alone here? So, 2 into 3, 6 is left alone. Okay, so what we will do? We will divide by a 6 and then the remaining number will be 2 into 13. That will be the square root, that the number formed will be the 26. Look here, in this case, two numbers 2 and 3 are left for which grouping is not possible. Hence, to get a perfect square, 2 into 3 must be eliminated. Eliminated means isko hatana hai. So how are you going to remove it? We should divide 4056 by 6. That's what I said. 2 into 3, that is a 6. So with the number 6, we will divide and we'll get the number. Whatever is the resultant number is a perfect square. Now this is your exercise 3.3 of page number 63. Let me change the color just a minute. So the question is, what would be the possible ones digit of the square root of the following natural numbers? Possible ones digit they are asking. So possibilities can be many. Now here if you see for the second one which I have done, okay, so 2, 4, 3, 3, 6. Now the number is a 6. What is the number at the ones place? It is a 6. So either the number can be 4, because the square of 4 is what? 16. It should have a 6 at units place, or the number should be ending with a 6, because the square of 36 is 36, again it is ending with 6. So any possibility can be there. So as both of them when squared give 6 at their units places, so that's what they're asking, like what should be the possible ones digit of the, when you find the square root of this number, what number should be should it be having at its units place. You can take a small example. Suppose if I write a number as 2, 7, 3, 1, okay, now 1 at units place. So when you find the square root of this number, what is the possibility that it will have a 1 at its units place? You know that 1, when 1 is squared, it will give a 1 at its units place, and when 9 is squared, it will also give a 1 at its units place. Okay, so same thing they are asking. Now question number 3. Is 180 a perfect square? If not, then what least number should be multiplied so that it becomes a perfect square? So first they are asking, is it a perfect square? We will prime factorize 180. You can see here on prime factorizing we see that 2 is in pair, 3 is in pair, but 5 is not in pair. So we will say it is not a perfect square. Now they are asking, if it is not a perfect square, with which number we will multiply? You can see 5 is all alone here. So what are we going to do? We are going to multiply with a 5. Okay, so when you will multiply the number with a 5, that is when you will multiply the number 180 with 5, you will get the new number as 900, whose square root is 30. Clear? Now here are some of the questions to find the square root by prime factorization method. They are already explained to you. You just prime factorize the number, you will see, and after that, after prime factorizing the number, you will find the square root. This should be written in the square root. Okay, so the square root of 7744 will be, you can see, the pair of 2, I have written them in a single form. Now here again single, single and single. Okay, same concept will be applicable in finding the cubes also. But in cubes, what we will do? We will form the group of 3. Okay, same concept. Here we are forming pairs, but there we'll form the group of 3. So the marked questions are your homework. Now, question number 6, is 2352 a perfect square? If not, find the smallest number of which we multiply it now to make it a perfect square. Again, you will prime factorize the number. After prime factorizing, you will see that one of the number or any two or any of the numbers are without the pair. Then they are asking with which number it should be multiplied. Suppose 5 is all alone, so you need to multiply the number with 5. You will get a new number, and for the new number, you have to find the square root of that number. So that was all for today, my dear students. You have your classworks and homeworks. Do them on time. Thank you. Have a nice day.